Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This is going to be a really quick video to show you perhaps what is my favorite technology, which is screen capture. And we're going to look at a particular technology called Snagit. And very quickly, I'm just going to show you five reasons why I think in teaching and learning, this is one of the most useful technologies that you can work with. Sit back, watch this video. I think you'll be surprised. So let's start with using Snagit for flipping our classes. So let's imagine, for example, that I'm a teacher trainer, I'm doing a teacher training course, but I don't want to talk about Bloom's taxonomy in the classroom. I want to do a recording about Bloom's taxonomy and share it with my students. Now, this is a super short presentation for the sake of this example, but all I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Snagit and I'm going to choose image, a video capture, because I'm actually going to capture the window and record myself talking over it. And I'm going to click here. Now, I don't have to go full screen when I record myself talking over a PowerPoint. I can just more or less mark out the area of the screen. And then when I'm ready, I just click on this button. Don't forget, it's going to collect my voice as well. So it'll record my voice as well as everything I do on the computer screen. And I'm going to start my presentation. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and this is just a very short presentation about Bloom's taxonomy. And what I want to look at is how Bloom's taxonomy is relevant to us in language teaching. My name is Russell Stannard, and I am from teachertrainingvideos.com. Now, if we just click over to look at Bloom's taxonomy, here you can see the taxonomy. And what we're really talking about when we look at Bloom's taxonomy is that these are lower order thinking skills and these are higher order thinking skills. Now, I can pause at any time if I wanted to just pause the recording, and then I can go back and continue. I won't do any more. Of course, I could have more pages and click through those. I'm going to click on the stop button now and just play back that video. And there it is, all made for me. I'll just play it back. See, very simple for me to do that. Now all I need to do is click on File, just up here, click on File and click on Save As. Save that as a video onto my computer screen, and I can upload it wherever I want to upload it. So I'm going to call this Bloom's Video, and I'm going to just save that onto my desktop. Click on Save, and just to quickly show you then how that will actually look in the end. There is my video, my Bloom's video. We're just going to click on it and it plays back immediately. And I could actually now, I could upload that into Moodle, into Blackboard. I could put it on a website. I could upload it into YouTube. I could put it into my Google Docs. I could do all sorts of things with it. But it's a really quick way of making a video and then being able to share it in a flipped classroom scenario. And of course, we've done that with a video, but we could have done that with an image, we could have done that with a text, etc. In this second example, we're going to create a banner. Now, I'm not very creative at all, but let me just show you how simple it is to use Snagit to create a banner. Okay, so what I've done is I've searched for some images of myself. I've got one here that's actually sitting on my website anyway, so I'm just going to image capture that by using Snagit's image capture. I can just click on that and I can mark the area of the image I want, and I can kind of get rid of that space and just have the image like that. So I'm just going to click there and make sure that that's okay. So now what I need to do is that immediately comes into the Snagit editor, is I need to stretch that out because I need to make a bigger canvas. So I just pulled the canvas out. Now I'm going to click here and add a color to the canvas, and I'm just going to play it safe now and add white. The next thing I need to do, obviously, is to add something inside of that. So I'm going to click here and I'm going to write some text. I'm just going to mark the text area out that I want to use. I can always make it bigger or smaller. Now I've got Arial, which I'm happy with. 36 should be okay. I'll go with 36. I'm just going to put where I've got the wrong, let me just make sure that I've got the chosen font and just click again. Where is Russell presenting? So just add that onto the screen, and just going to position that slightly differently so I can use that button to kind of set the presentation. Now, one of the nice things about Snagit is that there are these effects that we can make use of. So I'm going to click on the effects, and the one that I'm going to choose is this bevel. And so I'm just going to click on that. Now I'm quite happy with that. So all I need to do now is, and it's just outside of the screen capture, but I'm just clicking on File, Save As, and I'm just going to save this onto my computer as Presenting Banner, and save that onto my computer. Put it in Russell and put it in Montage. In fact, let's put it there. And then click on Save. Now I can save that as lots of different file types, but JPEG is fine. Click on Save. I've now got that image, and I'm now going to put that image into my screen. Now I'm not going to show you that, but I will show you the result so you can see what it looks like. Now I'm looking at that on the screen, and I probably could do a few more changes. I could just move that text up slightly, so I can always go back and just re-edit it. But I just wanted to show you how simple it was for me to do that, and that is one of the great things about Snagit. It's really good for creating banners. Now this third example is incredible. I'm going to show you how you can use Snagit to image capture a whole page of a website, even if that page is scrolling. This is a very special facility in Snagit. Very simple to do, let me show you. And it's got some great uses if you want to capture the content of a whole page and then, for example, mark some indicators on it, perhaps call outs or arrows, etc. Now I've got my web page here on the screen. You can see it's a scrolling page. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Snagit. So I'm going to click on Snagit. I'm going to click on Image Capture, but I'm going to choose Scrolling Window. And now what I'm going to do is click on, and you'll see what actually happens. It starts to mark out the area for me here, and I can click on this button. I don't have to do anything. Snagit will do this for me. I click on that. Snagit now begins to scroll through the page for me, and now it's going to capture that in an image, and it will open it immediately in the editor. I just have to wait a few seconds for that to happen, and there it is on the screen. Now obviously that is a huge image. Look at the size of that. So at the moment we can't kind of view the whole image, but easily now I could resize that. So I'm going to click on Image Resize. Now you can't see that, it's just slightly outside the window, but I'm just going to resize that, and I'll just take it down to about 1,000 pixels. It will automatically update the height as well. I'm going to click on Apply, and now we can see that image, the whole of that page scrolled. And I could begin now to augment this image by, for example, clicking here and adding, say for example, an arrow onto something. If I wanted to, for example, highlight a particular area, for example, I might want to highlight my blog. So then I can click, add an arrow, and then add a text that says my blog. This is another great thing about Snagit, is that you can use it to augment a picture, and we'll look at that in a minute. The next example I want to look at is how we can augment an image. That is, we can take an image and then we can add arrows, we can add text, we can add lots of things onto the screen and then save that enhanced image. Now I did touch on it in the last video, but I want to look at it as a separate issue just to show you how many things you can actually do to an image to augment and enhance it. Very, very effective and very quick again. Now I think this next example is really going to surprise you, because whenever I present this, people are so amazed that you can do this. I've just gone to Google, I've searched for the word computers, I've chosen images that I'm allowed to reuse and to modify. I'm going to click on a particular image, so I'm going to take this one here. I'm now going to go to Snagit and I'm going to image capture that. So I'm just going to mark out the area of that. That'll do. Just doing this very quickly, okay? That'll come straight into Snagit immediately. Now, I've already pointed out that we can augment our picture. We can add arrows onto the screen if we want to do that. We can, for example, add text onto the screen if we want to do that. And we can do all sorts of other things. But I want to point out something that is really, I think, incredibly useful. And I'm going to click on More, and I'm going to come down to this one called Step. And I'm going to use Step, and I'm going to use Numbers, and I'll do them in blue, to basically turn this into a worksheet. So I'm going to say, right, number one, because that's the screen, number two, that's the mouse, number three, that's the computer, number four, that's the mat, Number 5, that's the cable. Number 6, that's the stand. Number 7, that's the keyboard. Now what I can do with this image now is immediately save this into a Word file. It's very, very easy for me to do. Okay, I'm going to actually click here, just sort of simply click on this button here, copy all. Now you might not be able to see that, it might just be slightly outside of the area that I'm recording, but there's a button here called copy all, and I'm just going to click on that image. Now all I'm going to do is open up Word. So now we've got Word open on the screen, and I'm just going to paste that image in. Remember, I clicked on copy all, so the image is now copied. There it is. And now what I can do is add my, for example, write the correct vocabulary. And I can start number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7. And I've created myself a worksheet in seconds. That's one of the reasons why I love Snagit so much. I've saved the best for last. This is incredible. This is the thing that I use Snagit the most for. I'm going to show you how in seconds I can create a video and then I can add that video to YouTube. And this is literally, doing this will only take me 2 button clicks to have a video up on YouTube and ready to use. I might be exaggerating, it might be 3 button clicks, but let's just show you how easy this is to do. So let's imagine, for example, I wanted to do a quick tour of my website. I wanted to make users aware of all the facilities on my website, and I want to put that onto YouTube so that people can watch it. So I'm going to simply go to Snagit, and I'm going to click on video capture. I'm going to click on the capture button and choose the area, and I'm going to kind of mark an area out, say about that big. That should do fine. Okay, now I'm going to click on the capture button and begin to do my mini recording of me presenting my website. Hi, my name's Russell Stannard. This is teachertrainingvideos.com. Please come to the website and make use of the videos. They're all free. There's a newsletter that you can sign up to here. But if you're not interested, just click on this button here. Now, when we come to the website, you've got all these sections at the top. All these pages are free. All of them have free video content. Then please click on the blog. That's particularly popular. And that's got lots of very quick videos that show you different technologies that I use. Blah, 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 blah. Do the video. I'm going to click on the stop button. All right. Now, that video is instantly ready. Watch this. I'm going to click. Now, again, this is just outside of your view, but I'm clicking on the button called share. And I'm going to click on share on YouTube. And I'm going to click on send to YouTube. All right. So that's 2 button clicks so far. And now I'm just going to put introduction to teacher training. Now you have to, when you work, add something up onto YouTube. You do need to add a description, so I'm just going to copy and paste the same description in, and you do need to add at least 1 tag. I'm going to choose URL because it will send me back the URL. I'm going to set this as unlisted because I don't want to make it public. I don't want to see people to see it. And here's the 3rd button click. Now that video is now being uploaded onto YouTube, but incredibly, you'll see what will happen in a minute, is that already it's told me now, URL copied and clipboard. I can now get that URL, so I've just clicked on it. That means now that that video is already on YouTube. So let's go and visit it on YouTube. So I'm just going to open up a new tab. I'm going to paste in, because remember, I've just copied that link. I'm going to paste it in, and I'm going to click on enter. 3 button clicks, well 4 now we've actually going to view the video, and there is that video, and I can play it back, and there it is on the internet straight away. In other words, seamlessly I can create a video and share it onto YouTube, and that is the power of Snagit. Hope you found those videos useful. Please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots more videos about different technologies. If you're particularly interested in Snagit, there's a whole section on Snagit and Jing videos. The 5-minute blog section is also really popular, where I just do very quick presentations showing users technologies that they can use very, very quickly. And of course, very popular is the top 12 videos, and currently the most popular technology is Snagit.